Guys, welcome to my channel. Welcome if you're new. Make sure to like, subscribe, and let's get right into the video. So today, I am going to try out a nail kit. And I got that at Goodwill for literally $5. I was so excited when I saw that. So I had, of course, to get it and take home. And let's just see. It comes with 6 different poly gel, and I already saw that apparently they put an other poly gel in here than from Renmol. And I already tried some Renmol poly gel before in my other video. If you wanna see it, make sure to link it down below. Anyway, so this is what it is, and yeah, let's start swatching. So the first color is Low Blue. I hope you pronounce it like that. It's nice, like a light blue. A baby blue. Next is this color, Diamond Silver. Oh, that's pretty. Look at the glitter. Next is Glaring Beauty. Oh my goodness. Look at that. Gosh, the camera doesn't even catch it, but it's so beautiful. It's like an iridescent glitter. I actually think I might go with that today. The next color is Bobbi Blue. Alright, looks like a kind of like a mix from blue and violet. And the next one is Diamond Green Blue. I don't know if you can see it, but it looks somewhat greenish in real life. And the last one is the pink from Subway. I don't know what else comes in this kit. I should probably do some research and see, because I'm curious now what color I'm missing. And it's just a normal nude. Alright. Here are the poly gels after they've been cured. And I think I'm gonna be using the iridescent one, and I don't know yet. Let's see. I don't know what design I want to do yet. I already did my nail prep and put on a peel off base coat, and already sized out my nail tips. So I'm just gonna put them on real quick and I'll be back. Here are the nails, and I glued on all the nail tips. Now I will be cutting off some of the length, and I want to do like a longer nail set today, so I'm not sure how long though. Wait, just like that. Okay, I think that's good. Now we'll be taking my handful and just like reshape the nail and take the shine away. This is what the nails look like, and I cannot like really go in deep because this is what happens with the peel off base coat when I file, and I want to keep the peel off base coat on, so I'm gonna put a layer of base coat to all of my nails. I'm gonna be wiping off the tacky layer with some alcohol. All right I will be using the Diamond Green Blue, and just apply to the tip of my nail. For my slip solution, I will be using 91% alcohol, and my brush for model ones. And I'm just gonna start patting the poly gel in place. And from what I can tell, is that the poly gel is really stiff. Well, I guess it's always like this with like glitter poly gels from my experience, but it's not sticky or something, so that's good. And to be honest, I kind of like prefer the more stiffer poly gel over the more loosened one, because otherwise it's just runny. Just gonna try to like blend this up here a little bit. Just take off some of the poly gel. Just too much. I actually really like the consistency of this glitter poly gel so far. From what I could tell when I did the swatches, the poly gel without the glitter is way runnier. Alright, and I'll be curing. Okay, and I only did a thin layer because I have to encapsulate it since I'm gonna do like be doing an ombre. Alright, and then I'll be using the pink one from Subway. I don't know. That came in the package. And this one is really, really soft. I do not like that at all. Yeah, this poly gel is so runny. And just again, this poly gel is not supposed to be in there. I guess the person that donated this just put it in there and kept the one that was supposed to be in there. Alright, and then I'm just gonna like blend it down in here. I must say, even though it's really soft, it's okay to work with. I mean, it's not my favorite and I probably wouldn't get it again. But I'm also so used to my card, which is more on the stiffer side. I think that's good. And I will be curing. Alright, and now I'm just gonna be encapsulating with my MACART clear poly gel. Alright, this is what I got so far, and I'm still kind of like trying to figure out what exactly I want to do. So I think I want to use the Glaring Beauty, and I guess I'm gonna do it on here. Okay, and just pat the poly gel in place. So this poly gel is way stiffer than the other one, than this one. I guess it's because it has bigger glitter particles in it. I mean, it's not terrible to work with. It just takes some time to put everything in place. But isn't that color beautiful? I'm so loving this glitter poly gel. It's so pretty. Like, look how sparkly it is. You cannot even see it on camera that good, but it's really pretty. Alright, and now I will be encapsulating the nail. And I actually like started to get a liking to this poly gel. Even though it's really soft, it's a little bit runny, but not terrible. If you work fast enough, you should be able to handle it. just like that I can lay the polygel so fast and I'm done. For someone that just started, I would not recommend that, because like I said, you have to work fast with the polygel in order for it not to float all over the cuticle area. Other than that, you can't complain. I think for this, I want to do a French tip. Alright, now I'm just gonna take my nail file and crisp the edges. Right, so this is what the French tip is looking like. And now I will be going in with the low blue. I really wanted to try out this one as well, just to see how the consistency is of this one. And it's definitely sticky. This polygel is definitely way harder to work with than the glitter ones. I don't think I like this. I'm just gonna take this off. Just gonna take the green blue and go in here. I guess I forgot to record, so yeah, I'm shaping and filing my nails, and I finished my pointer finger, so sorry about that. Okay, so here are the nails after they've been shaped, filed, and buffed. I'm gonna wipe them with some alcohol real quick, get the dust off. All right, and let's get to the nail art. So I was thinking, I'm not really sure what I want to do, so I might use these, maybe also these elk ones. I don't know yet, some rhinestones. I'm just gonna improvise. I'm gonna need some rhinestone glue from a card. We're using a top coat. Maybe just gonna use the snake. I don't know. I think I'm gonna go with these. So what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna see if I like it like this or not. First, I'm just gonna play a layer like this. I'm not sure where I want to rhinestones. And then I'm gonna go over with some top coat. Alright, I think I wanna place it like this. Maybe like this. Okay, I don't know yet. Take some of these. I'm not sure if I like this either. I feel like it's out of place. I'll take this off. Maybe Just put on some butterflies. I will be applying some cuticle oil. And here to finish nails.
I think these turned out so cute. And as for the poly gel, I would definitely recommend it. It's so easy to work with, especially with the glitter ones. I wasn't too big of a fan of the regular ones without the glitter. They're just really runny and sticky, so it's kind of hard working with it when I tried it on my pointer finger. But other than that, I think the colors are really beautiful. And yeah, that's it for today's video. I hope you liked it. Make sure to like, subscribe, and I'll talk to you next time. Bye!